since being stuck here. I find myself staring down at the planet for hours on end. You'd think I'd get sick of it. But even now, there's just something about it I can't put my finger on. It just pulls me in. I know what you're thinking.
Well, yeah, that's how gravity works.
But it's more than that. I don't know. I haven't even told you about the probe yet.
Thank you.
spent weeks building the probe. Canary headed up its construction. The Lantern 2, it was called. We were all given a role to ensure its success. Mine was to plan its trajectory and pilot its descent. It felt good to work together on the probe, even if it was Canary overseeing it all. So far, all the information we'd gathered about the planet pointed to it being mostly habitable. It was exciting. We thought we were about to touch down on what could someday be humanity's next colony. Well, as per how we do things here, the probe launch did not go to plan. That's not quite accurate. The launch went fine. It was the landing that left a lot to be desired. probe was crammed with equipment. There wasn't a piece of data this thing couldn't collect. But we wanted more than that. We wanted samples. The plan was that once the probe landed on the planet's surface, it would embark from one end of this ravine to the other. Pistachio chose the location. Along its way, it would collect a variety of samples. Once it reached its destination, it would launch a capsule of the samples into orbit for us to collect. Simple, right? So, back to the launch. All was good until the probe reached the planet's atmosphere, when instead of slowing down, it started speeding up. It just kept accelerating towards the surface. We couldn't do anything about it. We were sure it was going to crash. And then it just seemed to fall straight through the ground. What's more, it kept going. We lost signal maybe a minute later. Canary says the heat from entry must have fried its telemetry or something. My guess is that it was doing its best to get away from her. Look, I understand the importance of keeping fit. I do, really. But Vermilion's mandatory daily workouts were a burden on my soul. We had to wear these wristbands that would track how far we'd run on any given day and relay our progress back to Vermilion. Naturally, I endeavored to find a shortcut. Initially, I just tried to cram all of my week's quota into a single day, leaving me with 6 days off. Genius, right? I just about managed it, but Vermilion told me that not only was that borderline dangerous, it was just not how this works. Anyway, I eventually found a use for those cats I was telling you about. Turns out they get around quite a bit, so I just attached my wristband to the most excitable one and forgot about it for a while. It took Vermilion longer than I'm comfortable admitting to work out what I'd done.